Good morning, students. This is third part of the poem A Thing of Beauty by John Keats. As we all know very well, The Thing of Beauty is Joy Forever by John Keats. This poem is an extract taken out from the epic Endymion. Okay, and I have already mentioned in my previous videos that Endymion has four books, 1000 lines, and we are reading only a few extracts of that epic. Okay, so A Thing of Beauty is a Joy Forever. I have already mentioned you in this poem that Endymion is a shepherd. Okay, poet imagines himself a shepherd. Okay, Endymion. And we have come to know that Cynthia, otherwise her name was Selene. Selene and Cynthia, and you will find in some of the books it was Dinah. Okay, so she had a love for Endymion shepherd, and then she came from heaven, made love with Endymion, then she left. This process had been going for so many years, thousands of years. But finally, one day what happened, that when Endymion woke from his sleep, so he would like to search Cynthia, and he searched her everywhere. Means he searched her everywhere, to whom? Endymion shepherd searched Cynthia. Okay, so finally when he returned on the Mount Latmos, means after his after his search, that was not fruitful, because his search was in vain, because he did not find Cynthia. So he quoted this line, A Thing of Beauty is a Joy Forever. So A Thing of Beauty theme is the very opening line of the poem. A Thing of Beauty openly recites the very theme of the poem. What? Any beautiful object, suppose in case a mobile is beautiful, whatever, is always treasured in our mind, because it provides us eternal and everlasting joy. But if you feel anything is beautiful, that thing should give you forever joy. But if that thing is not giving you forever joy, then it is not beautiful. The happiness that anything beautiful provides never fades into nothingness, but multiplies manifold whenever it returns to our mind. So this is the concept. Whenever you think for that thing, it will give you what? Charm. It will give you happiness. It will soothe your body. It will give you relaxation. So if a thing is beautiful, that thing should be what? That thing should remain with you forever, and that thing should give you forever joy. Fine. So, A Thing of Beauty belongs to a romantic genre. The poem is written in rhyming couplets. I have already mentioned you, rhyming couplets means, suppose in case my, dry, give, heave. Okay, so these last two words are, if matching, we call it rhyming couplets, and the rhyme scheme is AABB. Explanation. First stanza I have cleared you. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness. Poet says that beauty is eternal. It is forever. It never fades away. Rather, it increases with the passing time. Okay. But instead, our love for it enhances with the passage of time. Means what? Rather it increases with the passing time. The perception of the poet regarding beauty is that it never goes off with the passing time. Rather, it beautifies more and more. If you see beautiful mountains, then that memory will last in your mind forever. Suppose in case this scene would make you happy or will soothe you. Okay, thing of beauty is a joy forever. It gives us pleasure. For the poet, beauty is like a what? Beautiful shade. But will keep a bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams, and health and quiet breathing. Beauty acts like the soothing, relaxing shade of the trees, which helps all the creature to sleep peacefully and enjoy good health. Means if a thing is beautiful, suppose in case you are taking your mobile is beautiful, but do you think that your mobile allow you to sleep? No. So how can you say that your mobile is beautiful? So poet says that beauty acts like the soothing, relaxing shade of trees, which helps us all the creature. Means it is not there that everything is a tree, but whatever thing is beautiful, that thing should give you relaxation. Like the trees give us water, with the under the shade of the tree we feel relaxed. Suppose in case you are running and you want to drink water and sit under the tree, then what you feel? You will feel over there happiness. Okay, so beauty acts like a soothing, relaxing shade of trees, which helps all the creature to sleep peacefully and enjoy good health. Okay, so for the poet, beauty is like a beautiful shady tree under whose shade all the creatures can sleep peacefully and enjoy good health. Fine. Then next is stanza. Therefore, on every morrow are we reading a flowery bend to bind us to the earth. So what does poet says over here? Poet says here, therefore on every morrow are we reading. Reading means what? Reading means surround and circle. Jab hum aise kuch guthte hai na, to hum usko kehte hain reading. You can see over here reading. When you make garland, okay, when you encircling something, okay. So poet says, therefore on every morrow are we reading a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Kya hum nahi banate phoolon ki mala? Means what does poet say over here? Keats stresses the unbreakable bond of man with nature and the earth. Poet says that every day in the morning you wake up with new positive vibes. Do you feel that in morning you don't want to go somewhere? No, in morning we shed our all negative, you can say complaints and all, and we start our day with positive vibes. We start our day with, you can say, happy moments. So the beauties of earth fascinate man. Every object of earth is a source of happiness. Every day we are weaving a flowery wreath to bind us to the earth. Means poet would like to see over here. Poet says that every day it is the beauty which fills us with spirit to live. It is the beauty which builds the desire. It is the beauty. Which beauty? Beauty of happy moments that we spend. Okay, suppose in case if someone dies, okay, but you are not going with that person. You stay in this world with the beautiful moments you spend somewhere. Okay, so it is the beauty which builds the desire in us to live through, in us to live. Though there are sad moments and cruel people around us. Fine. So poet says over here that therefore on every morrow, that daily in the morning we all are waking up and we connect with this world, with the happy moments, with the beautiful objects of the nature, a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Okay, so Keats feels that every morning we weave a beautiful strings of flowers or memories which help us to support ourselves and motivates us to live our life to the fullest, instead of burdening our lives with pain and suffering. Okay, so poet says, therefore on every morrow are we reading that daily in the morning, that it is the beauty which fills us with spirit to live. It is the beauty which builds the desire in us to live, though there are sad moments and cruel people surround us. Fine. So over here, then we will come to know further. Poet says that spite of despondence of the inhuman dearth, of noble natures, of gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways made for our searching. So poet says over here what? That without beauty, the earth is full of gloom and sadness. There is gloom and sadness. Without beauty, the earth is full of gloom and sadness. There is cruelty all around. Okay, spite of despondence. Okay, so these are you can say old words. In spite of despondence of the inhuman dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways made for our searching. Means, without beauty, the earth is full of gloom and sadness. There is cruelty all around and lack of good natured people. See over here, this boy is very sad. Okay, so our life is full of darkness. Our life is full of negative attitude. Why? Here the poet would like to say that without beautiful object, our life is full of negative approach. The earth is full of cruel people. The earth is full of, it is the beauty of the God who has created the beautiful world. But earth is full of what? Earth is full of inhuman nature, inhumanity. Okay, so poet says over here that we should leave this kind of the attitude, and we should leave the beautiful objects of the world. Last line is, of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways made for our searching, means that in this materialistic world we all are searching the beauty. That is not very easy to see the beautiful, what, the beauty of the life in this materialistic world, because this materialistic world is giving you what? Inhumanity and the darkness. Fine. So without beauty, the earth is full of gloom and sadness. There is cruelty all around and lack of good natured people. Okay. So thank you. Have a nice day. And I hope that you will go through this poem and we will understand the next stanza, that if the world is full of negative attitude and all, then what is left in this world? Then what is left in this world? What is there in this world to soothe us? So we will understand that thing tomorrow. Thank you. Have a nice day.